double fist pumping. Let's get physical. Okay, that is the weirdest segue. I don't know how to come back from that, other than to just go, anybody here into musical theater? Me too! I grew up on musical theater, and it is a huge reason why I got interested in performing at all, so I feel very fortunate that I was exposed to that at a young age. Thanks, guys. You know who you are. When I moved to New York, I got the coolest opportunity. I was approached and asked if I would be interested in trying my hand at writing music for a Broadway show.
I know! It's the coolest!
I'm so excited. What? A-R-T. Yeah, it's true. A-R-T. Art. Comes in many forms and mediums. Painting. No. I know what you're talking about. But everybody else doesn't. Anyway, let me finish my fucking story. This is good apple juice. Anyway, God, fucking just get to it, Sarah. That's what I'm thinking to myself. Anyway, I got approached and asked if I would try this, and of course I said yes. This is an absolute childhood fantasy dream to have anything to do with Broadway. So this has been an amazing just exploration of theater, and I am just learning so much, and I have so much respect for everyone involved in that community. And I'm a year and change into this process, and I've written a first draft of this show, and some of it's pretty okay, and some of it's really fucking bad. And it will never hear them, they will never see the light of day. You're welcome. But I would love to share with you one of the songs that I think is pretty okay. And it's the stage adaptation of a film called Waitress. I don't know if you know this movie. It's an independent film that came out a handful of years ago starring Carrie Russell. Felicity. Her hair. I know it too. I think about it all the time. And it chronicles, Carrie plays the lead in this movie, and it chronicles the life of this woman who is this incredible pie baker, genius, magic woman. And she works in a southern diner, and she's married to this horrible, douchey, prickish man. And she's plotting her plan to leave him, and then she gets pregnant with his baby, and she's like, fuck. And, you know, she looks at her life and she realizes that she's not where she thought she would be. And I just fell in love with this story and with this character in particular. And even though I don't have the exact same circumstances, you know, I'm not married to someone I don't love, or I don't have kids I don't want, but so many of you do. You know what I mean? I think we can all really get with that. So this is the part in the arc of her journey where she's looking back at her life and just reflecting on who she has become and who she feels like she's lost. And it's called She Used to Be Mine.
I like cheese.
Mm-hmm, yeah. I like cheese too, sir. It's cool.
It's not simple to say most days I don't recognize me with these shoes and this apron, this place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to then no, I'm not anything that I used to be. Oh no, it's true, I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken, but won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. It's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite anything or two. For the girl she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, growing stronger each day till it finally reminds her to fight just a little. She's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is always mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she is.